This is Deepseek, a Chinese AI model that may have just upended the global AI landscape. In this video, we will explore how Deepseek bypassed Western sanctions, why it could wipe out trillions in big tech value, and how it is pushing us into a new AI era, the AI Wild West. Hello and welcome to Scriptor channel. I'm Scriptor, an AI researcher and a behavioral economist. After graduating from Columbia University, I spent 5 years in China as a Forbes columnist, studying the country's technological rise and how it is shaped by AI. Just last week, DeepSeek released a new model on par with the most advanced Western AIs. Previously, many assumed China was far behind in this AI race, especially with US restrictions on cutting-edge AI chips. Yet overnight, we discovered that not only has DeepSeek caught up, but they also open-sourced their model. It is now available to anyone, everywhere. But the real shocker isn't merely that China found a way how to bypass US sanctions or decided to give away this technology for free. No, the most revolutionary part is that DeepSeek has found a way, wait for it, has found a way to build AI that builds another AI. And that's the core of this breakthrough. From now on, AI makes AI. It's a phrase that might sound futuristic or even sci-fi-ish, but this is happening right now. It transforms everything from how models are being trained to how new technologies come to market. But how did DeepSeek, how did China do it? DeepSeek uses AI to train AI by a method called distillation. This concept isn't entirely new. Jeffrey Hinton, for example, discussed it years ago. But DeepSeek appears to have perfected it at scale. And here's how it works. They use two separate AI models, a teacher model and a student model. The teacher model is a large and powerful traditional LLM model, and it typically costs billions of dollars to train such a model. And the student model is a much smaller and leaner version. And the way how it works is that the teacher model creates training data set, creates training samples. And these training samples, they are later being used to teach the student model. And the core innovation here is that this training set that is generated by the AI teacher model is so much more efficient at actually transferring the knowledge. It is like hundreds times more efficient than the way it was done before. So this is how, by distilling the knowledge from the bigger teacher model into the smaller student model, DeepSeek creates smaller models that are faster and cheaper to train while retaining near equal intelligence. There are two analogies that we can use to make this concept more clear. The first analogy is online learning. Just like how online courses can compress what previously was like a 4-year university course, and now you can compress it in just a few months. So the same way, AI distillation condenses a lengthy and resource-intensive model training process into something much leaner and faster. And another example is how vodka is made. Instead of leaving grapes or grains to ferment for months, like wine or beer, you just distill the essential spirit in mere days. And it's faster, denser, and highly potent. Similarly, DeepSeek distills the knowledge of a large and massive LLM, traditional LLM model, into a smaller one, into a student model, achieving near equal intelligence at a fraction of the cost and time. And how this distillation helps bypass sanctions, you may ask. Well, here's the thing. technically you still need high-end equipment to train these big models, a teacher model. Well, unless you use a pre-existing open source model like Llama model, for example, which is what they the DeepSeek actually did. After you have that teacher model, the next step is in that you need to train the student model. And it turned out that student model, because it is small and so efficient, it does not require high-end advanced equipment. You can use old generation equipment. It's sufficient to train it. This might be a wild example, but technically this distillation innovation makes it possible even for a semi-illegal crypto farmer hiding somewhere deep in the Inner Mongolia forest to train a state-of-the-art AI model. And that's how China sidestepped sanctions on the cutting-edge GPUs. So why does it matter? What does it mean for us? For big tech, the DeepSeek innovation is deeply unsettling. Because for the first time, the speed of AI progress has become so fast that the companies no longer can monetize their investments. Companies pour billions into infrastructure, into AI infrastructure like hyperscalers, and they expect to recoup this cost over time. But if AI iterates so fast that each new innovation overtakes the previous one, even before it even goes to the market, the entire profit model breaks down. For example, take Project Stargate announced last week. OpenAI has committed to investing $500 billion in new infrastructure, assuming that hardware is a bottleneck. But now we know that this is not the case. And the question is, will these investments ever generate a return? If you stop for a moment here and you think about it, it becomes clear that this is not a minor one-off phenomenon. This is a fundamental shift in the business environment. Investments become obsolete before they can generate a return. This cornerstone principle of capitalism is now under question. These are big tech companies with a combined market cap of around $25 trillion. And today, major tech companies built on services like search and social media and e-commerce, they could find themselves disrupted by this lean and cheap and easy to replicate AI. Where previously a team of 1,000 was needed, now a team of 10 can do. Size is no longer an asset, it is a liability. Which is why we are about to enter the Wild West AI era. Previously, frontier models were so expensive that only big tech companies with endlessly deep pockets could build them, could afford them. And now, with AI making AI, with this AI distillation, more people, like small teams or even individuals, they can create frontier-level AI models. The barrier to entry has fallen sharply, like dramatically, almost to zero. It is like the Wild West. No large player remained, and all what is left is a man with a gun. The gun, in this case, is an AI model. A gun that reinvents and recreates itself faster than anybody can copy it. The fastest gun on the street. So where do we go from here? Well, the DeepSeek's new approach reveals that now, with this AI making AI concept, the biggest bottleneck is no longer hardware. It's a software. That's what the new bottleneck is. The software methods that are behind training. The problem is that this enables small players to challenge the big tech. And this is why we may be witnessing the largest capital destruction in modern history, with this big tech at risk of losing their trillion-dollar empires to a wave of unknown AI startups emerging from literally from nowhere and doing that faster than big tech can possibly react. So we are entering Wild West territory, ruled by a lone man with a gun. But what do you think? Are we truly entering this Wild West era with AI free-for-all startups popping up here and there, like across the world? Will big tech adapt, or will it collapse under the weight of its own investments? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. And also, don't forget to subscribe to our newsletter. This is probably the easiest way to stay in touch. All right, I'm Scriptor, I'm signing off. If you want more insights into AI breakthroughs and the impact on our world, subscribe and stay tuned. Because one thing is certain, now that AI is making AI, the game has changed forever.